大起公的马尔的根子的果然大五，知道蒙古骑兵果然厉害无比。眼见自己兵马被歼，
A former Hong Kong
Police
spokesman of criminal intimidation announced that
5,000
And U.S. China trade talks get nowhere in Washington.
在城入边搬石混木，加固城防。
Two former University of Hong Kong students have been convicted for their roles in last year's chaotic Hong Kong New Council meeting. But Billy Fung, who used to be president of the student union, was found not guilty of intimidating a staff member.
城街施汗已经将呢座城封俾我，我好想保存呢座城池完好无损，希望速航建造玉石区焚之灾啊！但系城中呢个大众非法敦府里坚持抗战，一怒之下杀死术赤派嘅劝降使者，依靠坚固嘅城墙封死，紧闭城门。
扬言要同蒙古人决战到底。察合塘固掌兄术赤嘅意见，坚持强攻。佢系亲自率领大军攻城啦。因为玉龙杰赤附近冇山石，察合塘岸就搏以术建议，用桑木代替炮石，先将桑树干锯成木块，浸喺水入边增加重量，然后投射出去。
喺察合台一声命令之后，攻城开始啦。蒙古士兵高声叫喊住，将射石器同弓箭用兵棒咁向城中打过去。跟住，蒙古军队团团向前移动，佢插喺城墙嘅根基，将蒙古大旗插上城头。士兵爬上城去同守城嘅士兵肉搏。城内嘅百姓亦参加咗战斗。
佢哋登上城头，用刀剑、用木棍、用砖石爬上城里嘅蒙古士兵膊头，以显示佢哋抗敌嘅意志。双方死伤好多，蒙古军队仲攻唔入城去，反而喺城外留低咗无数嘅尸体。败兵翻嚟之后。
兵发嚟之后，兵弟两个又开始争吵啦。术赤好啦咁啊，兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟两个又开始争吵，点打仗啊？兄弟
事关前一日晚黑，佢系从周围村落上嚟几个年轻女人，攞完帐入边公子淫落，被巡赤发现，曾经当面斥责佢，要将嗰几个女人送去骷髅营入边去。阿合和并冇应承。
The center which came into operation today is responsible for intelligence exchanges with mainland and overseas bodies. It's also tasked with strengthening communications with banks and government departments. Those with questions on fraud can call 224-4-4-9 and seek help from officers. Authorities have granted approval and for a consortium to become a new investor of IK. The communications authority said whoever top tier passed the first of two stages of assessment, which changed the shareholding structures at cable TV and broadcasting TV. It said the equity injection would provide funds to enable both stations meet investment commitments under their broadcasting licenses. Whoever top would then hold around 40-54% of voting shares in iCable upon further approval. Education Chief Kevin Jones said today the government will make sure to allocate and implement its extra resources as soon as possible. The pledge came after a day after the Legislative Council narrowly passed extra funding for the education sector. When a Wong
report.
Secretary for Education Kevin Young was spotted at the annual bookfare this morning. Reporters wanted to know whether he settled on an undersecretary yet. The minister said he was still thinking about it. Asked whether a candidate's political stance would have any effect, Young said it would be just one of many factors. Regarding the $3.6 billion funding that was passed by LegCo yesterday, Young revealed he already has plans on how to use it. His bureau plans to send out letters to all public primary and secondary schools in the city, informing them of arrangements for extra classes and teachers. As for the new $30,000 subsidy for students attending private universities, he says authorities are preparing to contact schools soon and hopes the money can go to students as quickly as possible. Chief Executive Carrie Lam was also at the book fair today. She said the government also wants to encourage students to read more and to think about how to utilize their resources to push that agenda forward. Winner Wong, TVB News. Overseas now, this year's trade talks between China and the United States broke up without a breakthrough. Still, both countries did agree to work together to reduce America's trade deficit. Sun Tao has more.
Officials from the world's two largest economies gathered in Washington, D.C. for the annual U.S.-China Comprehensive Economic Dialogue.
With the economic dialogue, my hope is that we can increase our focus on concrete and targeted commitments to address both short-term and long-term strategic challenges.
But the dialogue fizzled out fast when the Trump administration began listing steep demands. It wants increased exports of American goods to China and broader market access for U.S. companies.
We need to work together to maximize the benefit for both sides. But this is only possible as if there is a more fair and balanced economic relationship between the United States and China.
The U.S. also demands a cleanup of Chinese industries battling excess supply, one of the reasons why the White House is considering slapping China with steel tariffs. But such steep demands stirred up tension from Vice Premier Wang Yang. He made it clear America needs to be patient because confrontation will immediately damage the interests of both sides. Then he went on to suggest Trump should follow his own advice in one of his books. He quoted Trump as saying, coming together is a beginning, keeping together is progress, and working together is success. And with that, the dialogue ended in a big disappointment. News conferences were canceled, no joint statement was made, and no new announcements on U.S. market access to China. The talks were also expected to cover U.S. demands that China put more pressure on North Korea to curb its nuclear and missile development. Word has it, the Trump administration is about to sanction Chinese banks and firms doing business with Pyongyang. Still, the Chinese embassy in Washington cast the talks in a positive light. It said both sides made significant progress. Three members of U.S. President Donald Trump's inner circle, including his son and son-in-law, have been called to testify for Senate committees on the Newton reflection. Meanwhile, Trump admitted that having known Jeff Sessions would remove himself from overseeing the Russian investigation, he would never have appointed him as Senate Checker.
Next week, has the potential to deliver the most high-profile congressional testimony involving the Russian meddling probes since former FBI Director James Comey appeared in June. Former Trump camp chairman Paul Manafort, Trump's son-in-law and advisor Jared Kushner, and Donald Trump Jr. all say they're prepared to testify about a meeting they had with a Russian lawyer who said she had damaging information about Democratic presidential nominee Hillary Clinton. The lawyer, Natalia Veselnitskaya, also said she's ready to testify to clarify the situation. In another development, Trump told the New York Times he would never have appointed Jeff Sessions as Attorney General had he known Sessions would remove himself from overseeing those Russian investigations. Sessions recused himself in March after failing to disclose at his confirmation hearing that he had meetings last year with Russia's ambassador. Trump called his refusal very unfair to the president. Meanwhile, Donald Trump's almost one-hour conversation with Russian President Vladimir Putin, just hours after their first official meeting, continues to raise questions about what they discussed.
They had a brief conversation, and I'm not going to get into the specifics of the conversation, but again, this was a social dinner where the president spoke with many world leaders. There's a very different standard that you guys like to draw between this White House and previous administrations, and you try to create a situation that frankly just wasn't there.
They have a marvelous time chatting closely, very engaged, for about an hour. And this was noted by a lot of people that were around the room. They found it unusual, surprising, and of course there was no readout on this conversation between the two, something that President Obama, the Obama administration, because of the interest in Putin particularly, would have frequently done and did do. And indeed, until the story broke, we weren't going to find out.
Alan Brookner, TVB News.
A day after their latest healthcare plan collapsed, U.S. President Donald Trump told Republican senators to resuscitate a bill to repeal to replace Obamacare. James Aiken reports.
With renewed resolve and an apparent change of heart, Trump summoned Republican senators to the White House for lunch and a lecture.
For 7 years, you promised the American people that you would repeal Obamacare. We can repeal, but we should repeal and replace, and we shouldn't leave town until this is complete, until this bill is on my desk.
During last year's presidential campaign, Trump declared repeatedly it would be so easy to get rid of former President Barack Obama's health care law. But yesterday, after another failed legislative effort, Trump himself said it was time to simply let Obamacare fail. Now, Senate Republicans are vowing to revive efforts left for dead twice already this week.
Well, we just had a great lunch with the president.
But in the narrowly divided Senate, the majority leader needs to come up with something that both conservatives and moderates in his party will vote yes to.
So let me describe what yes is. It's the motion to proceed. We cannot keep the commitment we made to the American people to repeal and replace Obamacare unless we get on the bill. So next week, we'll be voting on the motion to proceed. And I have every expectation that we'll be able to get on the bill.
But with millions of Americans caught in the middle of a Capitol Hill showdown, opposition to the Republican-backed bill remains strong. A new poll shows Americans overwhelmingly want lawmakers of both parties to work out health care fixes to problems like soaring costs. But only 13% support Republican moves to repeal the Obama law without a replacement. And with another vote set for next week, it's not clear that a scolding from the White House will change the calculus in the Senate. J. James Aiken, TVB News.
Sports news. In football, Everton scored three stunning goals to defeat Dutch side FC 20 in a pre-season friendly. Jeff Tang takes a look.
All eyes were on Wayne Rooney again after he scored in a 2-1 win over Nigerian club Gor Mahia in his first game back at Everton. Dutch outfit FC 20 wasted a couple of great chances in the first half. Midfielder Danny Holler shoots wide in the 21st minute. Then he cracks the crossbar with a free kick shortly before half-time. Everton midfielder Kevin Morales silenced the Dutch crowd before the half-time whistle with a stunning strike from outside the box. Rooney's number was called in the 62nd minute. The all-time leading scorer for England and Manchester United had a chance at goal before being called offside. It didn't take the visitors long to find the net again when Aaron Lennon fired into the bottom corner at 73 minutes. Kieran Dowell made it 3-0 in the 81st minute. Rooney showed he still has a battling edge to his game at 31 years of age, though he demonstrated it with a horribly mistimed tackle. Everton's pre-season journey continues with a visit to Belgian top-tier side Genk on Saturday. Jeff Tang, TVB News.
Barry, 对皮肤不好的，不要吃烟啊。
7 and 32 degrees. And that's the news. Thanks for watching. Good night.
We know we can't go in because of the electronic gates. It's not acceptable for us to go through an electronic gate to go to pray. So we stand here in protest.
在周五的主麻日，是否要放宽措施？以色列内部意见分歧。有巴勒斯坦及穆斯林领袖呼吁，如果以方不移除金属探测器，就发起大型示威。 巴勒斯坦立法委员会决定关闭其他所有清真寺，让所有人集中到阿克萨清真寺来。有官员警告，情况非常严峻和危险。以色列军方已增派士兵戒备，总理内塔尼亚胡正评估是否移除金属探测器，但其右翼联盟的成员施压，要求他不要妥协。凤凰卫视综合报道。
英国与欧盟的第二轮脱欧谈判20号在布鲁塞尔结束，双方为就脱欧。